finishing process is, you know, of course, taking our final gravities, making sure our beer's ready. Once we're ready to go, we use a product called Biofine. Biofine is a, I want to say it right, it's a colloidal silica. There's no animal products in the Biofine, so vegans and vegetarians, you know, it's very easy for them. They don't have to worry about it. But we do. We use a product called Biofine, and what that does is that it actually, you got to mix in solution very well. You just can't pour it on top or it won't do anything. But once you mix the Biofine in your solution, it helps clear your beer so it pulls all the yeast down to the bottom. Once we get a clear beer, then we run it through a filter machine. We use a vertical velo filter machine that uses diatomaceous earth powder. And once we get our mixture of beer and our DE run through the filter machine, with the help of the Biofine, it runs through the filter machine, clears up any chill haze, pulls out any excess yeast that may have slipped through some grains or something like that. And then it goes into the tank as a super bright, clear beer. And then that would be the end. Then we carbonate, and we're old school. We have some Grundys. Grundys were mass produced back in, I think, the 80s to open up a large number of brew pubs. They're very hard to come by these days, but that's what we still use are Grundys. They're 217 gallons, and we force carbonate. So what we do is we have a stone that goes into a Grundy. We force carbonate it. Just from doing it several times, we know that we can carbonate it a couple times, and then we check it with the Zamen-Nagel, get our readings. We have a chart in there, depending on the temp inside the cold room, we can read. And then we know it's carbonated. From carbonation, it goes right on the line on tap, and then we're served good. We got beer.